So now, I'd like to introduce our guest of honor, Mr. Tariq Hilal Al-Barwani, currently Head of Corporate Affairs at Noris and the President of KnowledgeOman.com, the only Omani community portal. So far, that was founded by himself. His vast experience in information and communication technology goes back all the way to 5 years old. With a big round of applause, Mr. Tariq Al-Barwani, I would like you to come up on stage.
Ladies and gentlemen, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. So, I've been introduced as the head of corporate affairs at Noris. I'm not really head of corporate affairs right now. I'm actually working in the IT department. And I've been introduced as the president and founder of KnowledgeOman.com. Yes, I'm a member of this great, fantastic community platform. But today, as you can see, I am with a backpack. I am, and have been, like you all. So what I'm trying to say is that you all can do much, much, and again, much better than what I did. Why? Because the opportunities and the things that are available today are big, are massive. I have been in school, I have been in college. In fact, until today, I'm still in school. I'm actually working on completing my doctorate in management of organizations. So that's why I have the bag. And all the places that I go, I use my bag. But if you don't mind me, I'm just gonna put the bag down here so I can share the message and the tips that I have for you today. But again, remember, the bag and the books should never be down. You know why? Today, you are carrying the bag. Tomorrow, the bag will carry you. I love that. Great, great. It gives me great pleasure to be invited here today to be among the brightest young people from across all the colleges and universities in Oman, who would inshallah also be among the best leaders of tomorrow, who will be building the future for many generations to come. For those who don't know me, my name is Tariq Hilal Barwani, and I am pleased to be here, and I am your new friend as well. For those who know me, I'm very pleased to be here again with you today. Youth to Business is the name of the event I'm invited by AISEC, and the theme today is Build Your Future. I understood from the great team behind this unique event today that the aim is to get you all equipped with the right knowledge, the right skills, and the right tools to have for your future. And that's what I will exactly share with you today, inshallah. I led back a little bit and said to myself, or wow. So I am expected to address the brightest and the youngest people from all the colleges and universities in Oman. And then I'm also expected to address them all at once. And then I'm also expected to address them all who come from different disciplines, different majors as well. Business, science, art, economics, information technology, to name a few. But they all also come from different colleges and universities. Oh, wow. What should I say? Or what should I share that would simply meet the theme of the event today? That's not really easy, looking at only a few minutes that I have on my watch given by AISEC team, as that would require me to engineer a book. Again, different people, different colleges and universities from different disciplines. And yes, there are no newbies. Okay, so what size fit-all advice can I share that is unique for everyone and from anywhere in the world? Well, I have simply 10 things I wish to share today that if one takes it very seriously, will inshallah have a bright future. So what are they? Think tomorrow as you work out today. Do you know what is the biggest challenge today? Not in Oman, but all over the world. Students are living in yesterday's business world. That's because once they graduate, they go to workforce, they are somewhat outdated. Why? It's because what they are taught is for yesterday's business world. And why? It's because the speed of change is amazing. You know, like the speed of light. Everything today is old. And one needs to constantly think about tomorrow as you work out today. How? By looking at the horizon. By reading newspapers. Talking to people. Looking at projects. And initiatives that are being introduced, locally and internationally. Networking. And yes, making the best of such a unique event as today. The Youth to Business Forum. To learn what the business needs tomorrow in order to be successful. If there is anything I wish to share which is common for everyone, that would be think creatively, think differently, and communicate beautifully as you collaborate effectively. If Superman was here today, he would be the first one to let you know that the world today operates in a team culture. No longer is solo kind of a way that wins. No. Hone your skills and furnish your CV or your curriculum vitae, or others call it as resume. You will be amazed to see how many people have great knowledge, but no skills to back it up. Let me differentiate this a bit. By knowledge, I mean the knowing. By skills, I mean the doing. One may know how computers work in general. I'm talking, for instance, that I come from the discipline of information technology, but doesn't know how to fix computer in practice. What organization need today and the future is the skill set. And that is unfortunately what most organizations and universities offer to students. But yes, that's what you as future leaders need to do in order to prosper tomorrow. How? Well, there is many ways. Learn about the hot jobs of the different industries out there. And then learn about what it takes to fit in those jobs. And then later, try and join many organizations that are available today during your semester breaks or holidays to build that skills which is required. I'm sure you all are familiar about the concept of internships, right? Basically, organization provides students, that is yourselves, with the job to gain and hone your knowledge into a skill and experience without paying you money. Well, some do pay you money. But that should not be the objective. The objective is for you to be there, learn what they offer, and kind of problems that they have, situations, and issues that you could solve for them as a value. And yes, believe me, you will have the time to do it because most organizations today are busy working out on a solution to survive. You, on the other hand, can see it from a different perspective or a different angle that I shared in the beginning, that is, think creatively, think differently, communicate beautifully, and collaborate effectively. But now, by honing your skills, too, without forgetting to update that skills on your CV. If I ask a question to everyone here today, when was the last time you looked or updated your CV? I'm sure not only myself, but everyone would be amazed by how old that long is. Let aside how rusty that piece of paper is. No. Please update it, learn how to write, and make it dynamic. There are a lot of tools out there, thanks to information communication technology, and I'll be very, very pleased at the end of the session today to speak to you about it, or you could write me an email or join us at knowledgeoman.com. We have our Facebook where we have a great people out there who can share the information and tips on how to go about it. Search for opportunities that has potential to grow. Once you have written a nice CV, beautified it, next comes searching for opportunities that has potential to grow. That's when you start checking on what's new and what's hot out there, what's required from you, and finally, how can you join and be part of it. You need to gear your mind for the opportunities of the future and be a success when that future becomes your present. I'm sure your question is, how? Tariq, how? Well, the answer is, in alignment to what I've shared in my previous tips today, once you join an organization, ensure you understand what they do, the problems they have, the solution they wish to introduce, and yes, how could you be the opportunity that they're looking for? Ensure that you do your best and add that extra spark in the organization as a value. Ensure you network and make friends while you're working at the company. And yes, make sure you demonstrate professionalism apart from being passionate at what you do. Believe me, the most organization today want is not only your knowledge, but it's your skill set. They want the tools that you bring on board, that you could solve them, have the solutions, and add them the value. Be the jack of all trades, but master one. Be the jack of all trades, but master one. Yes, there are a lot of people who can do anything and can do everything. I can do this, I can do that, I can do the marketing, I can do sales, I can do computers, there are many people who come and say they could do many, many things, and that's really, really nice. There are people who can just do one thing and not everything, and that's also very nice. They can do one specific thing. You put them in a specific cabin and they do it very, very well. However, people that are jack of all trades, and believe me, also known as the generalists, tend not to fit well in a highly focused environment where it is required from them to deliver a specialized result. The same applies to the people who are master of one, where they do not progress quite well in a specialized environment, where they need to know what other functions do in order for the organizations to, because they are busy only doing one thing. So what happens is this. If you are the jack of all trades, you're able to know the different things that are happening in an organization. That's very, very good. But it depends on the type of organization that you're working for. Because there are some organizations which are focused. So if you do not provide that focused results, you're not useful, correct? Now the other way around, if you are the master of one subject and you do not know what's happening in the different part of the organizations, then you can only join an organization which is focused. And also if you join an organization that is not focused, then you don't tend to know how different things work together. Agree? Is that clear? So you need to really balance between the two. Now, if there is one thing that I can share today that is very, very important, but not widely used, unfortunately, is ask questions. Not many people do it, and therefore, not many people get it right. Asking questions is one single thing that can help a zero be a hero. Let me give you a personal example on this asking question bit. I had been taking a course called Discrete Math in Canada. And then English, not being my first language, one of the points our professor shared was the number 26. And every time he was referring to that in the computation class, and finally asked, Dr. Kelly, why 26, not 25 or 27? I asked that question because, I don't know, he kept on using the number, and I don't know what he's saying. So I asked that question, Dr. Kelly, yes, Tariq? You know, the guy with no money, the side sitting like that. I said, I got a question, why are you using, 26, why not 25, 27? That's what actually I usually do, and some people don't tend to like it, ask many questions, but believe me, that's the most important thing. Anyway, Many of the people in the class laughed at me and found that question and myself to be funny. And then at the end of the year, because I asked that question, I was among the top 5% of the university, and then again, a distinction and top Omani student in the Sunben University of Technology in Australia. What I always did, and I always do till today, is simply ask questions. That's a powerful word that one has to use. And in fact, many community activities that I do, and even the company that I work for, I ask questions. I always ask questions. Believe me, that's a very powerful word. So from today, what you all are going to do? Excellent. Practice, practice, and then again, practice. Oh yes, practice makes perfect. All the athletes, sportsmen, and the sportswomen, presenters, and the like, do one thing before they embark into their activity, which makes them successful. You know what is it? They practice, practice, and then again, they practice. In fact, that is the success formula. The magician on stage, you know, let me tell you something. Do you know the magician that comes on stage? All of them, most of them see them, right? They come and, you know, they put a napkin here and it disappears, or they take a flame, like a dragon, on the stage. You see that, right? What we see is that, whoa, he is a magician. How did he do it? Do you know what he does before he goes on stage? And?
Practice.
And?
Practice.
Oh, wow. So if we?
Practice.
And?
Practice.
And?
Practice.
We're going to do like what they do. That's the secret. Believe me. In fact, I'll tell you one thing. Today I came to give a presentation here. You know, before I came in the door, you all must have seen me went out, right? I went out. All right. And I actually went to the washroom. Anyway, before you get to the stage and give a presentation, many people find it to be very difficult. And yes, it is very difficult. But because I do,
practice.
And
practice.
And
practice.
Then you get it right. So today, ladies and gentlemen, if you do practice, 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 and everything you do, you will do it perfectly. Okay, that's the secret. I want to share another example that has happened to me at the university level as well. I recall when I was first in Canada, back over 10 years ago, when I was given an extraordinary offer of completing my degree within just as little as 3 years without having any formal qualification. When I was given that offer, I was told, Tariq, what you need to do is you need to take up some specific courses, and these specific high-end courses, they have some prerequisites before you do that. So I attended that because I had this extraordinary offer, but I did not have the prerequisites. When I attended in the class, this is what I was doing. The first day is whenever they speak on anything, I felt so good, I felt so good, I felt so great. It's easy for me, as all the other easy things that I've been having and I've been experiencing when I was in Oman. One of the subjects that came in, we were asked to do some assignments. Not actually one, two of the subjects, assignments. That assignments required me to have some prerequisite knowledge. You know what happened? I completely blacked out. And I remember vividly what happened. I went back to my room, picked up the call, and I called my parents. And this is what I said. What did I do? I was having a great job back in Oman. I was the internet services manager at OHI. I had the fat, good salary at that time, alhamdulillah. Why did I come here to put myself in this problem? I left my job. I can't do it. And I remember my dad said, Tariq, try your best. If you can't do it, then that's fine. And remember, at those times, we did not have WhatsApp. You know? We did not have Viber. We used the telephone, which cost a lot of money. And that phone was the phone that, you know, was the money I'm using from whatever my dad was giving it to me, you know? So I'm calling them to say, all right, I need to come back to Oman, I can't do it. And I said to myself, I say, Ya Allah, what I'm going to do now? And then I remembered the trick itself. Practice, practice, practice. I picked up the book. I started going through the questions, and I started reading all the materials. And I started doing nothing but practice, practice, practice. And believe me, today, I'm here. I've completed not only my bachelor's with honors, I completed with my master's distinction because I did. Great, I love that. If you got the ball, run with it. You see, the ball was faster than me. It even arrived on the screen before I... Okay, the moment you have the ball, run with it and aim to the goal. The moment you sway, you could lose the ball. And yes, it might also mean not getting it back. Or if possible, you need to work harder to get it back. Think about soccer. You know the football, the soccer. I'm giving, there's many examples, but I'm going to give you an example of soccer. When you're playing soccer, you have the ball. Stick with it. All right? Focus at it. And focus at the goal. That's what you need to do. Because the moment you start doing, what happens? So you need to focus. I'm using this concept as an example. But also, as you focus today, because as I said, Superman is not here today to share an example, you need to be working with your team. That's very important, ladies and gentlemen, today. Working with a team. There's no way you can do everything yourself. Believe me. You need to work with a team. So that's what you need to do. With the ball on your feet, I'm referring again to soccer being a sport that I play. You need to focus at the moment because the moment you lose the focus, the ball is no longer within your feet. The same applies in your life. There is too many distractions out there. And every day, the distractions become even larger than life. Learn how to focus and yes, do your best at whatever you're focusing. And I want to give another example. Do you know the treadmill?
Yes.
When you go to the gym, use the treadmill, right? You walk with a treadmill, right? If the treadmill, if you stop, what happens? It will take you back. And not even take you back. It will actually throw you back fast. So you need to be walking. And the world, ladies and gentlemen, it's moving that way. The world is moving that way. Every day is a new day. Believe me. And in fact, one of the community portals we're working with, called Knowledge Oman, if you want to know about the secrets that how we do things, is every day is a new day for us. Do not rest on your laurels, the comfort zone. To get on track, ladies and gentlemen, is very, very easy, believe me. To get on top is very, very easy if you follow the principle that I shared today. But to remain there is not. Most of the great people in this world that has made an impact and difference so as attained success at whatever discipline they were involved in, they know very well the importance of not resting in the laurels and saying, oh yeah, I'm already there, I've reached. Believe me, if the moment you start thinking that way, you will go down. And we have many, many examples. If you want soccer, we've got Diego Maradona. If you got boxing, we've got Mike Tyson. You see? And there's many, many examples. The moment, if you want, there's one secret. The moment you start thinking you already arrived there, then that's the problem. If you want me to share my example, believe me, every day is a new day. That's my bag. And I've got my papers and books over there. Because every day changes, and you need to keep yourself constantly updating yourself. If there's one important thing that I want to share with you today, is that never rest on your laurels.
Question, what is a laurel?
Is it clear? Yeah? Behind every successful man or a woman is a mentor. Every student has a teacher. Every team has a coach. Every boxer has a trainer. And yes, for me, my dad, who is sitting over there, he is my mentor, who has been a friend, a coach, and someone that I bounce back ideas for fresh perspective, support, and guidance. Believe me, you will be amazed by the results you can make by getting a mentor while you study, and after you graduate, and at workplace. I do it, and I'm sure you can do it too. Get a mentor. And that mentor should be someone that you trust, someone that cares about you, someone that wants to see you successful. The mentor can be anyone. The mentor can be your teacher. The mentor can be your parents. The mentor can be someone you you know, someone you live with and you trust. Anyway, in a nutshell, the mentor is someone that who has a knowledge, who has an experience, and want nothing but good for you. So from today onwards, what are you all going to do? Very good. Excellent. Find a mentor. That's very, very important. If you believe me, today, the people who have mentors are the people who do it very, very well. Because you can't see the world. You can see things in one way. But the moment you have a mentor, he or she is going to provide you a different perspective of things. So that's what you need to do. To conclude today, how do you expect to build your future in the global economy if you're living in yesterday's business world? Today's jobs require tomorrow's skills. In order to succeed in today and even tomorrow, you need to develop critical thinking skills. Remember it. It's not enough to memorize information and facts to do well on a test and exam. At the end of each semester and every year, you obtain your certificate or your degree. And then you expect a piece of paper that will guarantee you a ticket for a prosperous job. No. To get a good job in future, you must start today to think creatively, to think differently, to communicate beautifully, and yes, you need to know how to collaborate effectively. Thank you very, very much. This platform we have over here, called knowledgeoman.com, is actually part of the organization that I'm working with, and we have a number of people who are here today from knowledgeoman.com. We have a number of sessions and tools and techniques that can help you with reference to your employment, future tips, and so on. We have a lot of initiatives that we're doing it, and all of these are being done by the people. It's an organization that is owned by people, for the people, and it is by the people, for the people, and it's made of people. And we have great people here today with us who are going to be with you within the sessions today. You can register by going to knowledgeoman.com. We have a lot of opportunities for people who like to learn and to be part of making the future in Oman. And thank you very much. Now I have one last question. One last thing I have is, who is going to build the future tomorrow? Who is it? I can't hear it. All right, now I'm going to say one thing before I go. I appreciate that. That's what I believe and that's what I know. If you are not going to be building the future tomorrow and thinking about the opportunities that are available tomorrow, you know who will do it? If you're not going to do it, yes, you'll do it. But if you are not going to do it, you know what will happen? I'm going to share it with you.
Are you ready? Are you ready?
Wow. That boy on the screen, his name is Hilal. He was 1 year old at that time. He's 6 years old right now. And what I'm trying to say as an example is you need to be building the future tomorrow. It's because young kids have started going to Facebook and creating all those apps and programs and applications to build your future. Thank you very much.